法律 101。
朋友们大家好，欢迎收听在今天我们的法律 101， 我是胡美健。在今天呢，我们再一次的为朋友们邀请车祸专业律师 Mr. Le Tuten 和他的华裔助理 Connie 参加我们的节目，欢迎朋友们一块收听。如果你有相关的问题，在车祸在法律方面的问题要和他们两位讨论，请您电话直接拨进来 713-984-0424。好，接下来我们欢迎他们参加。Good morning, Mr. Le Tuten. Good morning, Connie.
Good morning, morning.
Good morning.
早上好，早上好啊！在今天呢，我们再度和他们在我们的底下的这个时间当中啊，关心和车祸和法律相关的问题。来，我们先看一下啊，就是我先整理一下我们今天听众传进来，在过去传进来的两个主要的问题。一个，这一个一位听众谈到的呢，就是他在 OK， 他在快车道上面紧急刹车，结果后面的车子撞上来，撞到了他。他现在想知道，因为他的前面地上掉了一个大的轮胎啊，等他看到的时候已经来不及闪开，旁边的车道有车，所以他紧急刹车，后面的车子也没有办法，他临时的，所以蹦撞上去了。现在保险公司呢，他现在在跟对方的保险公司现在在分隔彼此的责任。那他想要问一下，因为前面就是路上突然掉了个大轮胎下来，那这个应该要怎么算？这算他的错呢，还是算后面这一位就是驾驶的错？这是第一位听众他提出了他打电话进来的。那么第二个问题，这位听众呢就谈到的，就是他们自家19岁的孩子开车，那么已经有驾照了，那么现在开车，然后呢他现在想问的是说，开车的话他现在这样子说吧，19岁开车，旁边坐的是他的弟弟，那弟弟呢是现在刚刚满15岁，等于是说可以有一个student， 大概是这种就是练习的这种驾照吧，就是你旁边必须有人啊，有驾照，然后你再这样子开。他只在问说，19岁的这个刚拿到驾照，这样子带着他的弟弟这样子开车的话，让他弟弟也在试着开，在练习，是否是合法？警方会不会有问题？保险公司会不会有问题？如果出了事故，这个责任是否就会变成他还不满20岁的儿子得要一个人负担？
嗯哼 ，OK， 好，那两个问题，
对，麻烦，谢谢。
好的，Larry， we have two questions from the audience. The first one being rear-ended by another vehicle. So this driver was on the left lane, and because there was a big wheel in front on the, I think it's a highway, and he made an emergency stop. So when he made an emergency stop because of this wheel, all of a sudden in the road, he got rear-ended. And now the two insurance company, the other party, the one who rear-ended him, that insurance company is now working on liability on comparative negligence. And so he would like to know what would happen in this kind of situation. This is question number one. I'll have you answer this, and I'll present you with the second question.
Okay, my understanding of what you're saying is two vehicles going down freeways. One of them has an emergency stop, and then the second one rear-ends the first one. Is that right?
Right, because of a wheel, okay. The emergency stop is due to a wheel in front, a loose wheel in front of the vehicle.
Well, the law requires you to maintain a proper distance, even in an emergency situation. So mm-hmm. It's clearly the fault of the person who hit the rear.
So 100% the driver who rear-ended him, even if this is an emergency stop.
Yes, the norm, the only kinds of exceptions like that is if the first driver did something that increased the emergency at the time. But in this situation, they did not. So it's rear-ending. It's his fault for failure to maintain proper distance.
嗯哼哼哼，那我们首先回答第一个问题。那第一个问题，虽然这一个是一个紧急的刹车，好像那个我们打来或是问问题这个听众会不会是也是有责任，但是老板就说，无论如何你在道路上开车，你要保持一个安全的距离。所以呢，前面的那个人紧急刹车，你都是应该需要有那个。安全的距离，让你也可以去刹车。那所以呢，老板就觉得是完全是后面追尾的那个司机的全责。
OK， 所以这样子来讲的话，我们这位听众来讲，我想他听到了松一口气。他后面那一位驾驶如果听到的话，一定气死了。一定很生气。我们这位听众就说：“他说前面这个突然看到前面一个大车轮胎掉在那儿，他说那我当然要赶快踩刹车，要不然我就翻车了。旁边又不能够换，他一踩刹车，这个刹下后面车子大概来不及就撞到他了。所以他就说这个怎么办？后面一直说这个是他造成的。”所以他现在就觉得，我想我们这位听众，你放心了，我们这位听众提出来这个问题，今天一定笑，一定一整天都很开心的。
对对对，
后面这位，我们后面的驾驶就没那么开心了。好，那我们还有第二个问题，来。
第二个问题，那我现在问他。
好。
So the second question is about one 19-year-old driver who has a driver's license, and another is a learner driver's license of 15-year-old. They are brothers.So the audience is asking if the eldest son is being the passenger of the 15-year-old learner driver, being the driver. So in this kind of situation, can the 19-year-old who is not yet 20 and he is the passenger to the 15-year-old son when the 15-year-old son is driving, having the learner's driver license? In this situation...who will, if in case of any accidents that happen, then who will have the responsibility or have to be liable? Will it be the 19-year-old son or what will happen in case an accident occurs?
The driver, the young boy, is the one who's responsible for the accident. Now, if the boy is not 18 years old,then the parents of that boy insurance policy could be liable too on the policy. So you could have a policy that's on the vehicle, whoever owns the vehicle, that policy is number one. But the second policy could be the parents of the young boy being responsible on their policy. So it's not an issue as to whether or not you have a driver's license.Yeah, whoever the driver was and did not follow the rules of the road, negligent, then he is negligent. And the next question is, what policies will cover him? And, of course, the parent's policy will cover, as well as the policy on the vehicle, whoever owns the vehicle he's driving. The 19-year-old has no responsibility.
And the 19-year-old can be the passenger of the 15-year-old.
Okay, this is one I'm not sure about because it depends on the kind of license the boy has and which stage he's in. Because you first get a learner's permit, then you get another permit that allows you to, for 6 months, to drive with a person who is an adult. But I think the adult age is 21. Okay, so you have to look on the stages when they do the new Texas licenses.Are done in stage one, two, and three.
Okay.
So I don't know where he's at and what stage it is. But whoever, if you got a young driver who wants to drive your vehicle, you need to make sure to check his license, and it will tell you what stage of his license it is in and who needs to be in the vehicle with him.
Okay. 那我们分开两个方面来回答这个问题哈。第一个就是责任。那如果这个15岁的开车，然后有任何的出了什么事情，然后他有错，就是出错了。然后这个谁来负责？其实跟19岁的那个是没关，因为开车的人就是15岁，但是因为他还没满15岁，所以呢，他OK， 如果他出错的话，首先就要看这一部车。是哪一个保险？ 应该就是父母亲的保险。那如果父母亲的保险，比如说这一个车是另外一个 owner 的，另外一个车主，那车主的保险也要牵扯到车主的保险，爸爸妈妈的保险，如果是同一份的就是一份，如果是不同的两份的就是分开两份，都需要负这个责任。 OK， 那这个是责任的问题。第二个问题是那个19岁的就近可不可以就坐在那个乘客座位，然后让那个15岁的开车。那这一个要看清楚那个15岁的驾照，因为呢每一个驾照都有不同的阶段，那不同的stage。那所以每一个阶段他都会写明每一个阶段他的乘客需要是怎么样的人，或是有没有需要驾照要几岁，所以呢要看清楚那个 requirement，那个要求。是，好，所以呢我们这两位听众的问题啊，
在今天和Mr. Littleton 和Connie 我们在法律 101的节目当中， Mr. Littleton 为大家做了很详细的一个分析。所以在这尤其是我们这个听众朋友啊， 特别尤其在第一个case里面提醒大家， Mr. Littleton 一直强调的就是德州的交通法律是要求驾驶人要保持适当的安全距离， 给你足够反应的时间来面对突发的状况。 所以在这个高速公路上， 虽然速限65， 朋友们开到80的大有人在， 85的也不在少数。 但是你开了那么快，虽然没有交通警察在后面追着你开罚单，但是紧急情况发生的时候，你有没有给你自己足够的距离和时间来 踩刹车来停下来， 这个是Mr. Littleton 在我们这么多年的节目当中，每一次问到相关的这种问题，他都会特别的强调。所以我们也希望我们的听众朋友们在这一方面请一定要注意，请不要有侥幸的心态，因为紧急情况发生你来不及安全的停下来避开的时候，不一定是你自己受伤，也会造成别人受伤，法律责任方面是比较难的。希望大家注意。好，那么我想下来的话，我想请Mr. Littleton和Connie是否有在进来，在你在这个事务所当中，法律事务所当中比较重要的特殊的这个案子或者是问题，希望我们的听众朋友也能够一块注意。嗯哼。
So we have answered the caller's questions, and now are there any issues or anything like our cases that we would like to share with the audience or something that they have to be aware of? What do you think?
Well, I think, you know, the subject matter concerning having a driver who is underage, the parents need to be understand what phase the license it is and what the requirements are. And those requirements, some of them, for example, not driving it late at night, doing certain kinds of things with the vehicle, as well as who can be in the vehicle themselves. Mm-hmm. Okay? So those restrictions need to be mindful with the parents. Too many times I have found that the parents think, well, he's got a license, he can drive. I don't have to worry about that. That's not the law. And you end up with a situation where a young boy, 14, 15 years old, and he's got a learner's permit, and he's out there driving on the highway. And that's going to get the parents in trouble because they're required to make sure that these provisions are done until the child turns 18. The second thing is just a general advice. I mean, that is never let your teenager alone in a vehicle or with friends after 11 o'clock. The statistics clearly show that the number of accidents after midnight involving the serious death accidents, the majority of them are young people in a group. There's something about peer pressure that makes you think, oh, I can drive as fast as I want. Oh, let me show off.
Yes.
Or let me have a race or whatever.
I think we all have teenagers at home.
That's, So, it applies to younger people who are between, you know, the 18 to 21 years old, getting ready to go to college, and they never really got a license until recently. The more experience they have driving a vehicle with their parent in the car to guide them, is a greater chance they will avoid an accident when they go to college. So the whole point is, you're a parent for all of his other activities. You need to be a really sincere and very close watching parent when they get in that car.
Okay.
Because it is a something that will, peer pressure can cause them to do things you wouldn't even think they would even consider. But they all do it. To show off to that girlfriend, I guarantee you.
OK, Larry 就说那两个方面，第一个方面，那作为父母的，我们要很仔细，要很小心。小朋友拿到驾照的话，我们真的要很清楚的看他是怎么的情况可以开车，他要什么人的陪同以下可以开车，那他就要研究究竟他的驾照可以是怎么，虽然他有驾照了，但是呢不是代表哦好了他就可以自己开车，我们父母也是要去要小心一点，因为毕竟发生了车祸以后，如果他还没满18岁，也是父母的责任，也是父母的保险来处理，那这个要很小心。第二个他提醒的就是千万千万有年轻 driver 在家的，那就11点以后真的不要让他们开车，尤其他们是跟一群人一群朋友，因为朋辈的那个影响啊也是很大的，然后或者是我开车，我看你开给你看，开快给你看，或是怎么样，因为其实11点以后真的那所有的那个意外啊或者是伤亡啊的数字啊都是比较高，很比较严重的受伤、
okay.
所以一定要提醒年轻人就不要去 show off， 就中文是什么，
我们就叫我们人家说叫爱现爱表现
对，
爱表现嘛，就是有时候就是要在就像的确是有 peer pressure，我们不能够否认，尤其在teenager 的这种荷尔蒙的这种的催促之下，我们家里边啊，大家大概大部分还没有到 teenager 的孩子也差不多，以后你们也会经历过，总是会有 peer pressure 来自同伴啊，同学朋友之间的压力，比较彼此的比较，要不然就说你是乖乖牌。什么叫乖乖牌？就是你一点都不敢反抗，你没有自己的意志，你没有办法决定你自己的行为，老师说什么父母说什么你就跟什么，你怕你胆子不够，你不够勇敢，你不够有勇气，你不够 brave， 你没有 courage， 你不可以去 challenge。 所以呢，这样子的情形下，很多的 teenager 就像刚才 Mr. Littleton 和康妮讲的一样，就我要去 show off 一下，我别人有我也可以，为什么人家说为什么你不可以，所以家长们特别注意啊，要特别特别的注意，尤其是刚才 Mr. Littleton 谈到了关于这一个不满21岁的驾驶啊，请你们要查一下我们你自己的保险，还有我们德州尤其是跟保险公司来要查一下，在这种情形下这个保险是否是你要负担所有的责任，还是你的孩子不满21岁的孩子要负担法律责任，或者双方都要同时承担。所以希望我们的听众朋友在他们两位的这个分析下能够特别注意。好，我们有听众还在问到说，现在已经是后疫情时代了， COVID-19 已经应该说，他说虽然不能说 sayonara， 但是 at least 现在不需要像以前那么 worry 这样子多了。那么想请问一下，就是在事务所，在 Mr. Littleton 这个法律事务所，是否现在已经可，就是说可，他在问第一个，可以 walk in 吗？还是必须一定要预约？然后是否可以面对面在办公室和律师和这个康妮和你们讨论？他知道说 有这个电话啊，就是713-333-3333啊，这一个电话是你的电话，但是他想要更 confirm 一下关于现在的这安排是怎么样。
好，好，好，好。So, we have someone asking about our policies about meeting clients in the office during the pandemic. So even now, it is like a post-COVID time. So.Do we welcome walk-in? Can they come to meet us in person? And so what are our policies concerning, you know, an interview, face-to-face interview? And also about our phone number, so it's 713-333-3333. And so that number is still valid or so, and anything that they need to know about calling in.And to make an appointment if they want to meet us in person. Can you talk about that?
Sure. Not a problem. anything the client needs as far as an interview, we offer not only an interview by doing on Zoom, in person, whatever is necessary. There's no restrictions as far as not coming to the office.And even during COVID, we had restrictions of distance, wearing a mask, and that kind of thing to maintain it. But we've always had the office open for business. The second thing is the phone number 71333 is still working because I'm still paying the bill on it, okay? So,
Good to know.
That was a major investment to begin with, and I assure you it's still going to be there. And when the method we have in the office, if you have a special language request, such as Mandarin or Cantonese, Spanish, English, whatever it is, and East Texas English, that's my part, hey, all of those languages that we speak, and it's very evident on how to make that selection when you dial that number. Mm-hmm. We have also the website. It's got a lot of information on there and things that you can use. To answer many of the questions that you may have.
Okay.
So we're connected any way you want, okay?
Okay.
老板就说我们是欢迎听众朋友就打来可以跟我们约一个时间。我们就算是在最严重的那个COVID 的时候我们的门还是开的。当然如果要面见的话我们当时候就很多的大家保持距离啊大家要戴口罩啊之类的。那现在就没有那么紧张了。那如果客户想跟我们面见的话，或是我们也可以 Zoom 用 Zoom 来做一个 meeting 啊，也可以用 WeChat 的 video 也可以 meeting， 电话也可以 meeting， 很多的方法我们都可以跟客户connect 啊，跟他们就了解他们的问题，看我们怎么可以帮忙。我们那个电话。老板说那个当然是一直有在用，因为那个他还在付那个费用的，
付电话费。
对，电话费，因为那个number 那个号码实在是是我们的标志，其实
是
是代表我们的，
对，的确。
那对，713-333-3333，你打来的话，我们24小时都有人接听。
OK，
你用讲什么的语言中文、广东话、英文、西班牙语，或是老板讲的，东部德州东部的英文，我们都可以，我们都可以去跟你们跟听众朋友们沟通，跟客户沟通哈。那你就跟他讲你要讲的语言，他就那个接电话的人员就可以把你转到我们不同的同事去继续帮忙。
好。太好了，谢谢。所以呢，在朋友们记得啊，713-333-3333接听了以后，只要不管是录音还是有人，只要听到录音，你直接再按个二啊，你按个二就会接到华语部门。所以就是非常非常容易记，而且这么十几年、二十几年来从来没有换过，应该三十几年来没有换过。所以朋友们，这一个电话。就我想大家都记得，有任何这方面的法律需求，直接和 Mr. Littleton 的法律事务所联系。谢谢他们今天参加我们的节目，我们在下一个月的节目当中继续和他们讨论。Thank you for joining us today. It's 9 o'clock, and we're looking forward to talking to you in September soon.
Yeah, not a problem.
Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.